Let's walk through the second question of the series, Weekly Contest 274. And the question is, number of laser beams in a bank. Here in this question, we are given the position where laser beams are placed in the bank, and we need to identify the total number of laser beams that will be actually shot in the entire bank. There are a few rules to it, and we'll talk about those rules by the presentation that I have created for this. I'll explain the example there and also come up with the approach to solve this question. Number of laser beams in a bank, lead code 2025. It's a medium level question on lead code. However, I would like to rate this question in easy category. Understanding the question is of utmost importance. If you have understood the question properly, you'll be able to come up with the approach. Let's try and understand the question by the same example that was specified. Here in this question, we are given the positions of the security devices that are placed in the bank. For the first row, there are three security devices. In the 0th row, in the first row, there are no security devices. In the second row, there are two security devices, this and this. In the third row, there is only one security device. We need to identify the number of beams that exist in the entire bank. And as per the question, where a beam will be placed? A beam will be placed from each security device in a particular row, and it will terminate at each particular device in the next upcoming row. For example, there are no beams placed in this particular row, so we'll skip this row. We have beams placed in the second row, so we have security devices placed in the second row. So a beam will originate from each security device in the previous row, that is the 0th row, and it will terminate at each security device in the next upcoming row. So this makes it to two beams corresponding to this security device. This makes it to two beams corresponding to this security device. And again, we have two beams corresponding to this security device. In totality, there are six beams that communicate between the 0th row and the second row. So let's write six so far, and let's move ahead and see with respect to the second row, how many beams are originating. There are two security devices that are placed in the second row, and where can you see a security device in the upcoming row? There is only one security device in the upcoming row, which is the third row. So corresponding to each security device in the second row, one beam will originate, and it will terminate at this particular beam in the third row. So in totality, this makes up till two, and 6 plus 2 gives us 8, which is in sync with our expectation. Now comes the question, how are we gonna solve this up? So let's walk through the same example, and let's me just change the color of pen. Let's take red this time. What I'll do, I'll create a variable that will store the frequency of the security devices in the previous row, and let's name it previous security device frequency. And let's initialize it to 0. Let's start the iteration. So how many security devices does exist in the first row? There are three such security devices. So I'll multiply the previous count with the current count, and let's add it to the answer. 0 into 3 gives me 0. So answer still remains as 0. Also, I'll update the previous security device frequency to 3 for the next iteration to come up. So this gets updated to 3. And let's proceed ahead. Next, in the first row, we have no security device placed, so let's skip it. It's not our concern. Let's move ahead. Next, we see as the third row, where we have two security devices placed. So let's find out its frequency. The frequency comes out to be 2. We'll multiply 2 with the previous security device frequency that we saw in the previous row. 2 into 3 gives us 6. So let's update the answer with 6. And I'll also update the previous security device frequency to 2 for the next upcoming row. Let's proceed ahead. Next, we see the frequency of security devices as 1. So we'll multiply 1 with 2 and we'll add it to the answer. So 1 into 2, this gives me 8. And I'm done with the iteration. And the final value that is stored in my answer variable give me the result. Let's walk through the coding section, where we'll conclude the coding part. Here I've defined the previous security device frequency and initialize it to 0. I initialize my answer variable to 0, and let's start the iteration. I am initializing a new variable, current security device frequency. I iterate through the current string and I calculate the frequency of current security device frequency corresponding to the current row. If this value turns out to be greater than 0, that means I will have to update the current frequency device count into the previous security device count. I'll need to multiply these two up and add it to the answer. And once I have done this, I'll update my previous security device frequency to current security device frequency. In the end, once I'm out of this loop, I'll simply return the answer variable. So let's try this up. Accepted. The time complexity of this approach is order of n into length of each string that is given to us. So you can say it's n into m. The space complexity happens to be equal to constant time. We are not using any extra space. N signifies the number of rows that exist in the bank. This brings me to the end of today's session. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for viewing it. Have a great day ahead and stay tuned for more updates from Coding Decoded. I am coming up with the next question.